Hi my little hearts, welcome back. This video is for the 5th standard. The lesson name is Safety and First Aid. Children, first of all we will try to understand what is the meaning of the safety. Okay, casually we will hear the word that, see, while moving on the road or crossing on the road, be careful. This is the word heard by your teachers, your mother, father, elders, your brothers, grandparents. They will tell to you, be careful, okay? Be careful, okay? You keep your self safe, okay? So these are the things. Then what is keeping safe, or what is the meaning of the safety? So while crossing the road, we should be careful to keep ourselves safe. While crossing the road, we must see, or we must have an idea of the vehicle, in which route the vehicle is moving, then when to cross, where to cross, where is the point, where we have to stop, where we have to, the which side we have to walk away. So like this, these are the some rules are there, we must follow, because if we are violating these rules, there is a possibility of vehicle coming and the vehicle may come and rash to our body, or we may, after the accident, we may lose some hurt to our body parts, or we may lose some one of the body parts, or sometimes we may lose the lives. So in order to avoid these all situations, we must be careful, we must keep ourselves safe, not only on the road, even we can keep ourselves safe even in the at the house also, in the school also, in the street also, in the market also, in the park also. So like this, there are so many places where we can keep ourselves safe. Other than this, even we can keep our body safe even in the different seasons. So this is what the meaning, I hope you have got the meaning of keeping safe now. Then safety is, there are some major things from which we, our body or our life may cause very fast and very bad effect on our body, body and body parts, and or on our life. So for example, there are some danger things are there, like fire. You know, by hearing the word fire, we all make like this, because the fire is that much thing. And we must be safe from the water also sometimes. Not the drinking water which we have in the filter or the aqua guard. The water from the river, water in the lake, water in the pond, water in the ocean, water from the flood, water from the rain. So the heavy amount of water may become the dangerous things for our life sometimes. Then we have to keep safe from these things. First of all, we will learn about the fire. Then we know that there are many fire hazards takes place. For example, there may be the whole building is burning, the whole house will be burning. Sometimes we may burn our finger, our hands, even our face. So like this, chances will be there from the fire, these are going to be happen with us. Then first of all, the fire will in a small amount we will take while scratching the matchsticks, candling, or lighting the stove, lighting the diyas. So during these small things or small works, we may get hurt from the fire. And then other than this, while cooking or while using the electric appliances, and of course, these are the very simple things where we get the hurt from the fire. Then other than this, some fire hazards, as I told you, fire hazard in the factories, in the big shop, or on the road where the cotton lorry is moving or some other cloth materials are moving. So there is a possibility of getting fire when the cotton and the cloths may get, or they are going to catch the fire very soon. So like this, other than this, some factories and houses may get the fire because of some reasons or because of some negligency. Then now we got, how do we get the fire? That is, where we are neglecting regarding the fire, we will get the fire. That may be in a small amount or that may be in a big amount. Then how we can keep ourselves safe? There are some steps. If a small fire, as I told you, lightning or scratching the matchstick, striking the matchstick, lighting the candles, or while using the electric appliances, or that may be the gas leakage, it is cylinder or the gas leakage. So these are the very simple things even, and even this is the way from where we get the fire. For example, while handling the hot or burning items, we must be very careful. That is simple. While in the kitchen, while cooking, after cooked items, we must handle with a careful. This is the first one. While scratching the matchsticks and or lightning, or using the gas stove, or using the switches, or using the electric appliances, we must be careful. And for the electric shocks also, we will get from that also fire can be caused. For those, we must go for the regular checking of connections. The wire should be checked, the connection should be checked, and the fixation of the wires should be checked regularly, so that we can avoid like this chances. Then other than this, as I told you, we must handle the situation carefully, where presence of mind should be there. Whenever we are dealing with a fire, presence of mind should be there. Then even though we are taking care, or we want to keep safe, we are very much alert, aware, presence of mind, then also in the some situations, the fire burning or the fire putting on will take out. Then how to handle this situation? For example, we all know that if the fire or in the small cylinders and the small candles will be burned, we can off that one by blowing, or by doing like this, or using some thick cloth, jute cloth and all. So this is what the simple in a small amount of fire. If the whole house is burning, the whole building is burning, first our work is to phone to the fire station. Then we must go for putting off or putting out of the fire. We must try. And we know that if the fire is from the gas leakage and some other matchstick, because of the matchsticks or some other it has got from the paper, from other, or from the wind the fire has come, or with the help of the wind the fire is increasing, the amount of fire is increasing. So there we have to use the water, and then the small amount of the if fire is there, we will use the fire extinguisher. If we call the fire station, even they have the big pipes and all, they will do their work. There are many steps, and it will be very forceful, and it is going to put out the fire very soon. And other than this, there are some chances of getting fire from the electricity and even from the petrol also. See, if in the like this chances, if the current is from the electricity, we must not use water there, because water has the nature to catch the fire, or it may cause the shocks to us, because even the current can flow through the water also. So if the fire is from the electric wires and all, or electric appliances, we must not throw or we must not sprinkle water on that. So in this situation, we can use the sand, we can use the jute or thick cloths on that. We never use the water to the fire which is caused by the electric appliances or electric wires. And even if the fire has got because of the petrol, again here also we must not use the water. We can use the sand and even the jute cloth or jute bags or jute extended cloth material. So this is what how we have to maintain safety on the road also, and from the fire also, what are the chances we can get the fire, and how do we follow the steps to put out the fire. This what the we have discussed in this video, children. I hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this. And before ending this, you can write down the steps where we can keep ourselves safety from the fire, and even how the steps we can put out the fire from the different situations. I hope you will write this homework, and let us meet in the next video. Till then, take care of yourself and bye-bye.